Shut up and sit down.
Hi guys, this is Bigmeks Workshop and Paint Studio. I'm Dodge and today we're doing a green stuff video again because it's been a while. I know some of you have been waiting, a lot of our subscribers have been wanting these videos. I'm just going to show you the tools we need because this is a cloak experiment. I'm no master at making cloaks, so what I decided I'd try and do was come up with a new system that makes building cloaks really easy. In this video we're going to go through all the processes I went through to get to the end step. If you don't want to watch the entire experiment, just skip to the last 10 minutes or 5 minutes near the end and we'll have tuned everything up and we'll be getting some good results by then. But we're going to start off with our bit of cling film or giant sealing bag, anything plastic with the real smooth texture to it, and we're going to cover that in Vaseline as always because we're working with green stuff and we don't want that to stick. Now I'm going to start chopping some paper clips down, trying to sort of show you the size of the bit we're going to be using here. So you only need to pull away one part really and then snip that off. Oh no, it's about 1.5 to 2 inches at most, but knowing what I know now I'd recommend 2 inches, just so you've got an extra bit of paper clip to work with. This was a lot of trial and error, so like I said, if you don't want to watch the whole experiment, just skip to the last 6-7 minutes. Now all I'm going to do is I'm going to start making some tools to make cloaks with instead of just trying to make cloaks straight off the bat, because one of the problems everyone has with cloaks is that they're not freestanding when you sculpt them. There's no underneath surface to work with. I've seen a lot of people make them flat. I've seen people add slithers of green stuff and then blend that into something. I just thought I'd try something different. As you can see, all I've really done with this paperclip is cover it in green stuff, and now I'm going to give it a bit of a bend. This is why the paperclip length is important. You want to have 2 bits sticking out that end. And what we're going to do with these is we're going to use them as a template. Sorry about all that noise, I'm just shifting my chair. We're going to use them as a template to work the green stuff over. As you can see, because it's an experiment, I've made a whole variety of different shapes here. On the second experiment, later on in the video, we'll improve these. So this is the first attempt at this idea. And I was like, okay, let's stick down some blue tack. And the point of the paper clips really is that you can stick those into the blue tack, holding them in place rather than trying to do what I'm doing with this one and bend it down. As you can see, this particular shape, it's supposed to flick the cloak up at an angle at the side when we're working with the green stuff. But I wasn't quite sure what shapes we would need for this, so I made a whole variety. As you can see there, we've got something resembling the underneath of a cloak. Now I'm using some cling film or cellophane if you're in America, just that kitchen wrap for sandwiches, and I'm going to push that down into all those gaps in between the green stuff parts and cover that in Vaseline, because obviously we don't want our green stuff sticking because we want to make it malleable, we want to work with it. And I'm not building this cloak to any particular shape or size at this point, because I'm not quite sure when I started this where this was going to end up. So I've made something roughly cloak shaped, and all we really need to do, or the idea was, we just take this, get a tool and start pushing that into the underneath gaps. Now because of the shapes we've got, with all the bends, curves and raised and lower bits, we should have should quite easily start getting some shape we can manipulate that will look like a cloak. Now immediately while doing this one, I started to notice there was a bit of a problem with the cling film, but I put it down to the spacing in between the green stuff bits, and as you can see, that experiment was a complete fail. So let's go back to the drawing board with our tools and start again. Just tried using some different shapes on this one, change the technique up a bit and see what we can get. This particular cloak design I'm trying to do here, I'm thinking something along the lines of the Death Guard now, where they've got the They've got the cloak on the back, but it comes around the shoulder. That's what the long part's for. Because all these are going to do is give you something to fold your green stuff around while you're working. And because we've made them on paper clips and a mass variety of different shapes, you can make lots of different cloaks instead of making a push mold to just do one. Should, in theory, be able to make a lot of different ones. So again, I want to push the cling film in because I wasn't sure whether it was to do with it wasn't going deep enough because of the spacing in between the green stuff parts that I've put down. Now, for this one, the spacing did work a little bit better. We started to get something a bit better, or it could have been the fact that I changed the tools I was sculpting with. Started off pushing that in with my finger and immediately started to notice that the spacing has given me a much more depth to the cloak. As you can see, I'm using a different tool here, and all of a sudden we're starting to get some decent cloak shape. We're getting some good folds in there. It's not too difficult to do once you've done the building of the tool part. As you can see, there's a couple of folds there, and you know, we would leave this to dry to a certain degree so we could start manipulating it without it being sticky, allowing you to then fold your cloak around something. And as you can see, this one seems to be a lot more successful. We seem to be able to get in there with the tools more. We seem to be able to make sharper grooves, so it's a bit more dynamic. So something we've done on this one seems to be right, and I do think it was the spacing allowing for more depth. So we're on to the third attempt at this. This time, I didn't use any cellophane or cling film over the parts. It's the exact same underneath as well. I just took the cellophane off and covered the green stuff parts in Vaseline as well. Sorry, I'm half asleep. It is a Monday. I noticed because that wasn't there, yep, that middle part went straight down, a lot more depth and a lot more pronounced with the shape. And I'm using a different tool again here, back to the first one to see if that was part of the problem. Turns out it's not. The cloak just needs to be able to sink a lot further than you think it does. Now, all I'm doing is shifting those out of the way so the camera focuses a bit better. And as you can see, we're starting to get much more defined cloak folds and shape. I'm still going to continue to fiddle around with this for a while and keep the experiment going. Then I thought, well, we've got it on this bit of blue tack, and it's got the paper clips running through it. So can we manipulate it while it's still wet using the cellophane bag at the back? And what tends to happen when you do that is, yes, you can manipulate it, but you do lose control very quickly. And it starts to bunch up on itself, which can be useful in places. But I wasn't happy with the result of doing that either. It seemed to make it go a lot more flat. I mean, you can obviously work with that in your hand. So we know we don't need the cling film anymore. Then I decided that because the depth was working for us, to take some of these green stuff tools, obviously, I've just made some brand new ones. Now, it's the same principle with the long slithers, but I've made an underneath part that's got a flat bottom for them to stand on. The idea of this is these will be even more pronounced and will give us an even better way of, give us even more space to work with by pushing down the green stuff. And that's one of the old parts. I glued it onto another notch at the back. Now, didn't end up putting the cloak on this guy fully. And this bit that I'm showing you is for dealing with backpacks and other pesky things. I'll show you that later. We're going to push that into the cloak and then remove the groove that it's made, giving us space to attach the cloak to things. Now, I've attached it to the blue tack again, but now it's much thinner lines on a much, and then they're much higher. So obviously I'm going to cover that in a Vaseline. and this time my green stuff's going to be something a little bit more cloak shaped, because I think we're finally getting somewhere with this one. I mean, there's no limit on how many of these tools and shapes you can make for this, just kind of the beauty of it. Once you've made them all, you can just sit them in a box, and making a cloak should be really easy. You just follow the step from the last bit of the experiment and let it dry for an hour or two, and then attach it to your model. What I changed here was I attached the green stuff on one side first instead of the middle, sort of weaving it in between each one. Now that seems to work a lot better than starting in the middle and pulling it all in, because it's only attached on one side. If I push the sculpting tool into the middle, it's going to pull the rest of the material with it, which means it's much more malleable. So that's definitely something to take away from this video, is start at one side and don't attach the rest of it, because it immediately allows you to pull the rest of the cloak in, making it look more whole rather than, you know, bunch of grooves. You can see how easy that fell in there. As you can see, this experiment is finally getting somewhere, and it's really, really easy. All I'm doing is pushing those down a little bit with my tool, and the underneath part's doing all the work for me. So I obviously started on the left, I'm working my way to the right. But yeah, it sort of resolves the problem of having nothing to work against while building a cloak, and then adds the benefit of having something underneath to follow as a sculpt. And then I'm folding the last half around. What I'll end up doing with this is cutting off the excess. So just leave it a couple of hours, get a nice sharp knife, cut off the excess. But I do hate putting my X-Acto blades in anything like Vaseline or water to cut green stuff, but you gotta do something to stop it sticking. But if you get any unneat frayed edges, you can always wait for it to set and then sand those down. And that was it's just really, really easy to do at this point. So I think what I'll end up doing is making a lot more different shapes and tools for this. I want at least 10 going to the left, 10 going to the right, and a bunch of other shapes. But as you can see, I'm just poking that around, and the underneath is doing all the work for me. You can add in as much depth and as much detail as you really want to this, and manipulate it. If you don't like the way it goes, take it off, stick it back down, and do it again. Andy's just got in and is desperately trying to distract me towards the end of the video. Now, I was quite chuffed with the result of this one, except for the excess. So account for the sides being pulled in ever so slightly and make your cloak a bit wider than it needs to be. I mean, that was really simple once the tools were done. Now, because the guy I want to put it on has a backpack, I'm going to start using this bit. Could also be used for hoods, but this isn't the end of this experiment video. I will be doing a second part to this to see if we can perfect a bunch of green stuff tools that just make making cloaks a 2-minute job. Because I know a lot of people out there struggle, and there's a lot of different ways of doing it. I just thought I'll try and come up with something different and much more simple to do. Having that back work surface is a... It just makes this so much easier. I can't explain how much easier it is. And as long as you keep your tools either covered in water or Vaseline, nothing should stick, and you should be able to manipulate that for about half an hour before it sets. Now I'm just scoring a line where I want to snap the rest of the cloak off. I mean, after this, if you score it and you've got some unneat bits, you could just roll up a sausage of green stuff and attach that right along that edge and blend it in. And I'm not quite sure why I left this bit of video so long. I do apologise for that. But as you can see, my blade's sticking to the green stuff ever so slightly here, which I don't like, but I did put some new blades in recently and don't like getting them wet, because I don't want rust on my blades. As you can see, you can still get a pretty clean edge with that and just neaten it up with your sculpting tool. Again, just pushing the green stuff into the template behind it and smoothing it out. Now all that was really left to do was to take out that middle bit to make space for the backpack to go on. I didn't end up finishing this model because I want to use him for something else. It's halfway through being a colour experiment at the moment for some Nurgle videos I'm doing. And you can, as you can see, that template seems to work really, really well. All that's really left to do is manipulate it. I did leave it for like an hour or so to start setting, which made it a bit harder to manipulate. But maybe I'll, on the second experiment, come up with a better way of attaching these to models as well. And we're about done here, so thanks for watching, guys. I really hope that helps with your cloaks. I hope you subscribe and watch the next one as well. Hit like and share with your friends, and I will catch you on Thursday when we've got a Blood Angels tutorial coming out. Thanks for watching, guys.